Most people think soil plants and hydroponics are two completely different worlds, and that soil plants can never survive in water. But today, I'm gonna take some supermarket herbs, sage, thyme, oregano, and rosemary, and see if I can move them into my hydroponic machine. Will they survive, or just die in a week? Let's find out. If you've ever started gardening with soil, you probably know the struggle. Messy soil, pests, constant watering, and yet some people dismiss hydroponics as unnatural. But the truth is, the only real difference is the growth medium. Soil provides support, nutrients, moisture, and microbes. Hydroponics can provide all of that too, just in a cleaner, more controlled way. In another video, I explained why I quit soil gardening forever and switched to hydroponics. Check it out if you want to understand the six big reasons hydroponics changed my life. But today, we're testing whether soil-grown herbs from the supermarket can survive this transition. First, I soak the plants in water so the soil gets fully wet. This protects the roots when we remove the dirt. Once soaked, I gently wash each root ball in water. Slowly, the soil dissolves and washes away, revealing the true root structure underneath. Soil roots are often dark, rough, and battle-scarred, completely different from the pristine white roots you see in hydroponics. It's important to clean every bit of soil because leftover dirt can block water circulation or harbor pests and harmful bacteria. Next, I prune the plants. Take sage, for example. I cut all leaves above the first pair of true leaves. This reduces transplant shock, lowers water loss, and relieves stress. Bonus, these cuttings can be used for cloning, sometimes creating more plants. Now the roots and stems are ready. I carefully insert them into my hydroponic system, securing them with support. I personally recommend using the FreeBond hydroponic machine. It's semi-transparent so you can clearly see the roots, and with my specially designed Venturi system, the roots get plenty of oxygen to improve survival rates. The first week is always the hardest. Your plants may look droopy or tired. This is completely normal. They've just experienced a big migration and are adapting to a new environment. Hydroponics provides more concentrated nutrients and consistent water. So once they adapt, they thrive. I have to be honest, not all my cuttings survived. Out of dozens, only a couple took root. The cuttings were too young, too tender, and competing with mature plants for oxygen and nutrients. Next time, I'll create a special hydroponic setup just for cloning to improve success rates. And now, 1 month later, look at this. The sage has grown into a small jungle, producing healthy side branches and filling the room with fragrance. What started as a couple of tiny leaves is now a thriving hydroponic herb garden. The plants adapted beautifully, showing that moving soil plants to hydroponics is not only possible, it can be surprisingly easy. So, what did we learn today? First, transplanting soil plants to hydroponics is doable if you carefully clean the roots. Second, pruning reduces stress and can create new plants. And finally, hydroponics offers a cleaner, more controlled environment, making it easier for plants to grow and thrive. Now, I want to hear from you. Which soil plant should I try next? Tomatoes, strawberries, or something else? Share your ideas in the comments, and I might pick your suggestion for the next experiment. If you enjoyed today's experiment and want to see more hydroponic adventures, hit that like button, subscribe, and ring the bell. At FreeBonds, we're all about making hydroponics fun, simple, and sustainable for everyone. Stay tuned for more experiments and tips for growing your own indoor jungle.